Hello, once again, I'm John Shannon. Thank you for watching this DVD. Today's lesson is entitled Identifying the Church of Christ According to the New Testament. Our text is Acts chapter 2, verse 40 through 42, and Acts 9, 1 through 2. Stay tuned. Thank you for coming our way today. And you who are not members of the body of Christ, thank you for coming.
Amen.
Got a little unusual lesson today. I hope that you can see this from the back.
Good, preacher.
This is simply an introduction to my lesson.
Wait a minute.
Can you see that? This is a cow.
No, sir. Watch out, preacher.
This is a cow. I want to bring it all up so you can see a cow. All right, I think that's high enough. This is a cow. Now, some of you are laughing, say that's not a cow. Well, I'll tell you what I would like for you to do. When you leave here today, you really think already you know what a cow is.
Amen.
But you really don't know.
Right.
Because if you had to explain to a person what a cow looked like and they never saw a cow, you would be in a predicament, Paul Brown, to explain to
right.
them what a cow is and they never saw one.
Right.
Now, the reason some of you are laughing is because you know what a cow is.
Right.
But what about people who don't know what a cow is?
All right. Right. That's good.
Stay with me.
Amen.
Now, you think you know what a cow is. Well, let's do it like this. A cow has got a tail. There you go.
Amen.
Cow got 1, 2, 3 legs, 4 legs.
Right.
A cow foot is cloven footed.
Right.
Cow got hair.
Right.
Cow got ears.
Right.
Cow got eyes. Cow got a nose.
All right.
Now how come that's not a cow?
All right. Help us out.
Paul Brown, you follow me?
Amen.
When you go back to Texas, you tell those folks that I learned what a cow is. Is that good?
Good.
LB, I see you're looking and saying, LB saying, Brother Shannon, I've been in this world 80 some years. If that's a cow, I'm a young man.
Right. Well,
Doc, I see you're looking. Cow. Wait a minute. Now that's very comical. Tell you what you do. Tell somebody what a cow is that never saw a cow.
Mm-hmm.
Never saw a picture of a cow. How are you going to describe a cow to the person that really don't know?
All right.
Right.
You know, but you don't know how to explain. You better listen to the introduction.
Amen.
Amen. I got the attention there. All right. Stay with me. Amen. Since you don't think this is a cow, Rachel, we'll see can we find one.
All right.
And all right?
Amen.
Oh, just stay with me now. And when I was young, I would rush through it and wouldn't explain.
Mm-hmm.
I'm good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. All right, what do we have here now? This is a real cow. Hey, man. Now, if you got a bulletin, you have this illustration on the inside of the bulletin.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen. And you can use this illustration. Well, watch this. Do you know the difference between a hog and a cow? Do you know the difference? And somebody said, yeah, I know the difference. Well, I don't think you do. Watch this. A hog is in the swine family.
Right.
A cow is in the bovine family. Things after his kind. Genesis chapter 1, 11 and 12. 20 and 25, God has ordained, listen to me, every seed brings seed after its kind.
Right.
Listen carefully. There is no crossing of the kind.
Right.
I'm trying to wait till everybody gets seated, situated. I want you to listen. You can't take a hog and a cow and mix them. Why? Two different kinds.
Right.
Amen.
Two different kinds.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Every seed, Genesis chapter 1, 11 and 12, brings seed after its kind.
Right.
I'm trying to reach you this morning.
Amen.
Now, did the Jews know the difference between the both of them?
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Did the Jews know the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. Do you really know the difference? All right. Both have divided hoofs.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Right.
Pig got divided hoofs.
Uh-huh.
Both have four legs. One, two, three, four.
Yes, sir.
Both have a head. Both have ears, both have a mouth, both have teeth, both have eyes. Both has got a body, got hair, and got a tail. Now, how come that's not a pig? How come that's not a one I show? How come that's not a cow? Listen to me carefully. Similarity does not prove identical.
Uh-huh.
I know some folks, they look like a mule, but they're not a mule.
They're right, preacher.
That right?
Yes,
I know some people look like a monkey, but they're not monkeys.
Right. That's good, preacher.
I got you, got that. Monkey got hair, got eyes, a mouth, teeth, all that good stuff.
Right.
Now, you follow me? In the book of Leviticus, chapter 11, there were certain animals that a Jew couldn't eat.
Right.
You had it, Brother Fox? Genesis, Leviticus 11, and verse number 3 says what?
Whatsoever part of the hoof.
Wait a minute. Watch this now. Whatsoever part of the hoof. Read it.
And is cloven footed.
Read it.
And cheweth the cud.
Wait a minute. Go back. Some of you want to learn this. So let me take your time.
Right.
And go back to Leviticus chapter. Let's look at chapter 11 and verse number 1. It seems they're interested. They want to get this.
Amen.
And I'm going right along with it. I see they want it. All right, Brother Fox, you're going to read? What does it say?
And the Lord spake unto Moses.
What?
And to Aaron.
What?
Saying unto them.
What?
Speaking to the children of Israel.
Now listen to me carefully. Listen to the text. God is speaking to the children of Israel through Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Read it.
Saying.
Saying.
These are the beasts which ye shall eat among all the beasts that are on the earth.
No, anybody tell you that you can't eat animal? That's crazy, because God said way back then that a certain one they could eat.
Right.
Keep reading.
Whatsoever parteth the hoof.
Part the hook.
And is cloven footed.
And is cloven footed.
And cheweth the cud.
And cheweth the cud.
Among the beasts.
Among the beasts.
That shall you eat.
Now watch this here. They got to be cloven foot.
Right.
You got it. Part the hoof.
Mm-hmm.
Cheweth the cud.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what is the cud? See, I thought you say you knew what a cow was.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's a cud? Wait a minute. You need to listen. This is an introduction. Everybody need to listen. You learn something. Chewing the cud is when the ones in the bovine family, they eat a lot of grass and one time swallow it, and then they regurgitate it, bring it up, and they chew it again and send it to another stomach. So you thought you knew that. You didn't know that. Some of you didn't know. You ain't never heard of cud.
Right.
Got it? A hog doesn't do that.
Right.
Hog doesn't chew no cud. But I thought you said you knew the difference. I tell you one thing they know. You know the difference in the sound. A pig go oink, oink, and a cow go moo.
Right.
You know the difference? Come on, say amen. All right, keep reading, Brother Fox.
Nevertheless, these shall ye not eat.
Here's the one that the Jews could not eat. Read it.
That cheweth the cud.
That cheweth the cud.
Or of them that divide the hoof.
Read it.
As the camel.
Wait a minute, a camel. Read it.
Because he cheweth the cud.
He cheweth the cud.
But divideth not the hoof.
Wait a minute, his hoof is not split.
Right.
Hey, man. Amen. Hey, man, somebody here. We good?
Amen.
Now, wait a minute, if you never saw a camel in your life, the Bible give you a description of a camel. He chews the cud.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right. But his hoof is like that.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Read it. Read.
He is unclean unto you.
God says, Jews, you can't eat that. Keep reading.
And the coney. Because he chews the cud.
Read.
But divides not the hoof.
Keep reading.
He is unclean unto you.
Keep reading.
And the hare.
And the what?
The hare.
What's the hare? Wait a minute. As a rabbit.
Yes, sir.
A rabbit does what? Keep reading.
Because he chewed the cud.
A rabbit chewed the cud.
But
just like a cow.
Right.
But read.
But divided not the hoof.
His hoof is not divided.
Right.
His divided hoof like this.
Right.
Can't eat it. Keep reading.
He is unclean unto you.
Read it.
And the swine.
What?
The swine.
You know what swine is? That's hog.
Right.
Read it.
Though he divide the hoof.
Wait a minute. A pig's foot. Watch it. Just like that, he divided the hoof. Read it.
And be cloven footed.
And he's cloven footed.
Yet he cheweth not the cud.
He don't chew the cud.
Mm-hmm.
Now, wait a minute. You learn anything?
Amen.
Oh, you're learning something.
Amen.
You're learning something. Now, so if you had to, listen to me carefully. If you had to give a description of a cow and a pig, could you do it now?
Amen.
To a person who never saw one.
Right.
Wait a minute. We're talking about people who never saw a cow or a pig, and you try to tell them the difference. You're going to have a hard time explaining it to them.
Right.
Amen.
That's good, preacher.
All right. Let me stop here. Does that make any sense?
Amen.
Right.
Now, just because something is similar doesn't mean it's identical.
Right.
Amen.
All right. God has ordained that every seed, I'm trying to get them. Every seed brings seed of this kind. Now, right here, I have something that's called pinto beans.
Mm-hmm.
I've got enough in here to give each person in here at least two or three. If you go home and plant it, Paul Brown to Texas, plant it, what you think you're going to come up with? Pinto beans. Come on, wait a minute. That's what you're going to come up with. Because God has already ordained that every seed brings seed after its kind. This is corn. Got it? Everybody take corn seed, take it home and plant it. You don't come up with pinto beans. Every seed brings seed after its kind. I'm preaching just like their first graders. Now, I know you got that. Got that. All right? Now, let's start our lesson. The Bible says in Acts 2, verse number 47. Y'all stay with me. I know what I'm doing. I'm going to take my time and explain to you some things that you know, but you don't know. Amen. Let's stop a moment. Now, the Bible says in Acts 2 and verse 47, praising God and having favor with all the people, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Look at this. Look at it. Look at it, fellas. Identifying the church of Christ according to the New Testament. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. You know what people say? One church is good as another. A church is a church. All of them the same. Well, a cow and a pig are both animals, but they're not the same.
Right.
Every church you see is not the church of Christ.
Right.
It's good, preacher.
But people who never saw a picture of the true church, you don't know what it is. Because you say one is as good as another.
Right.
Now, going to identify the church of Christ according to the New Testament.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you got to go to the New Testament to find out what you're looking for.
Right.
Amen.
Not the yellow pages.
All right.
Amen. Nope. If you go to the yellow pages, you're going to be so mixed up, you don't know what to do.
Amen.
Right.
Because in the yellow pages, there's a lot of churches.
Yes, right.
Amen.
And when you pass by and look at the building, they all look the same.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But when you go to the New Testament, you'll find out something different.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
All right. All right. Wait a minute. If you went as a member of the Church of Christ, you went to Phuc Vinh, Vietnam, and there was no, somebody say it is a Church of Christ in Phuc Vinh. And I'm a member of the church and I know what I'm looking for.
Right.
You got it? You can take the New Testament and find out if it's the Church of Christ or not.
Right.
If you know what you're doing.
Right.
Come on, somebody say amen. Yes, Mike, is that making sense? Yes, all right. Let's look at this. The Church of Christ according to the New Testament. Not according to what people say.
Right.
Or what you think. But according to the New Testament. You got it? All right now. Jesus said in Matthew 16, 13 to 19. Jesus said, I'm going to build my church. Now my question is, did he build it?
Amen.
All right. Acts 2 and verse 47. It says, praising God and having favor, listen at me, young people, with all the people, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved.
Right.
All right? We got that right. Now, in our text, in Acts chapter 9, verse number 1 and 2, I want you to listen. Listen to me carefully. I don't want to lose you. I don't want to lose you. All right. Brother Fox, you ready to read?
Yes,
I think they're just about there. Acts chapter 9. Oh, I'm not satisfied. When you're moving around and so forth, I'm not satisfied yet. I don't have you. But I want to have you because I may not get you back here tonight. And I want to teach as much as I can.
Right.
All right? Acts 9, verse 1 and 2, it says what?
And Saul.
Saul, who yet, was Paul. Mm-hmm. Got it? Saul. Hey, man, I'm going to wait till these boys here. Get sitting right in here. Amen. How we doing? Saul, same as Paul, read it.
Yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord,
went unto the high priest
and desired of him
letters
to Damascus,
to the synagogue,
that if he found any of this way.
Wait a minute. It was something about these people that was different from everybody else.
Amen.
It was something different about him. If he found any of this way. Well, Paul, what do you mean of this way? It's something that these people are doing and something they're practicing. Nobody else in the world is like that.
Right.
What is he going to do? Read it.
Whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem.
Wait a minute. Now, Paul was looking for people in the Church of Christ.
Imagine.
Wait a minute. Why you say he was looking for people in the Church of Christ? Listen, listen, no offense. Your church hadn't gotten started.
Right.
Amen. There wasn't no Baptist church back there. Paul wasn't looking for no Baptist church. Amen. He wasn't looking for no Methodist church. He wasn't looking for no Pentecostal church.
Right.
He wasn't looking for no Catholic church.
Right.
What, Jehovah's Witness? Seventh-day Adventist? Nope. He wasn't looking for none of that.
Amen.
Why? Because none of them is up that way.
Right. That's good.
There's not but one church of that way.
Amen.
And let's look at this outline. We have the persecutor who was Paul. We have the people that are the disciples of Christ. Talk to me, somebody.
Amen.
We have the priest, the high priest. We have the papers.
Amen.
Wait a minute. Paul went and got letters. I don't want to lose you. Still with me, Kayla? Letters. Do you have a letter for the church you're in? When I was in the Catholic Church, I didn't have no letter.
Amen.
Now I'm a member of the Church of Christ. I got a letter.
Yes, sir.
Where is it? Romans 16:16. Right. Salute you one another with a holy kiss. The Church of the Christ salute you.
Yeah.
Now, amen. Now, I'll write that on the board. Now you put yours in there. You mean tell me you in something you don't have in writing? Well, how you think God going to... Now, is it in writing? Oh, I'm preaching now.
Yes, sir.
I'm helping somebody.
Yes, sir.
Because you didn't know that. Because you thought one church is good enough. You remember the hog and the pig?
Right.
The pig and the cow?
Right.
You know the difference? When you leave here today, you're going to know the difference between the Church of Christ and the New Testament and these denominational churches.
Amen.
Papers, place, Damascus, and the synagogue. All right? Practice. It was something that they were practicing that nobody else was doing.
Right.
And they, well, listen to me now. That if he found any of this way.
Amen.
Paul said, I persecute the way.
Yes, sir.
What? Persecute the way of holiness,
yes,
the way of happiness, and the way to heaven.
Yes, sir.
Paul said, I persecute the way. What Jesus said, Saul, Saul, why persecuted thou me? Well, Paul said, I persecuted the church, I persecuted the way, I persecuted Christ. Same thing as persecuting the church. Amen.
Yeah.
Right? And prisoners, and we might bind them and bring them to the Jerusalem. That's the text now.
Uh-huh.
And what we do now, you find now, find a duplication. What do you mean duplication? You know what duplication is? That's the same thing.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Now, let's look at the word. Definition of the word church. What does it mean? Definition, listen to me carefully. It's a Greek word Ecclesia. What does it mean? It means the called out ones.
Uh-huh.
Wait a minute. What is the church? Call out. Somebody repeat after me. Call out.
Yes, sir.
Call out.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Call out. Call out of the world into the kingdom of God, dear son.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Booker T, where are you? Booker T and his wife.
Right.
They answered God's call. The gospel
Amen.
Call.
Amen.
Doc, you and your wife, y'all answered the gospel call.
Amen.
You got it?
Amen.
You listening to me? The gospel call.
Right.
We're called by the gospel.
Right.
Wait a minute. God doesn't call anybody separate apart from his word.
Right.
Right? Is that pretty good?
Good.
Call. Is that pretty good?
Yes, sir.
That's pretty good, isn't it? So the definition of the church is the call out one. We are the call out ones.
Yes, sir.
Out of the world into the kingdom of God, dear son.
Amen.
All right. Now, we got 3 points. The definition of the church, declarations about the church, and descriptions of the church. And then today, now final duplication.
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy.
Amen. Good, preacher.
Yeah, you know, you have to educate people.
Amen.
Jesus said, go teach. I've got to educate this church in God's word.
Right.
I don't want you to leave and I don't want you going just jumping and shouting and don't have nothing in your head.
Right.
You got more religion in your feet and clapping in your hand and religion in your head. You
right.
got to have some sense.
Right.
Got to have some Bible in your head so you know what you're doing.
Right.
Amen. Now, let's look at declarations about the church. There was something written about the church that we are a member of watching before it came.
Right.
All right? Let's look at this. Is that pretty good?
Good. Amen.
Number one, watch here. The right person. Who's the right person? The right person, according to 2 Samuel 7, 12 through 17, is Christ.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 1, 5 through 8. That's talking about Christ.
Right.
It's got to be the right person to build it.
Right.
Hey, man, Jesus Christ is the only one that authorized to build a church.
Right.
All right? Right place. Where did this church, according to the New Testament, where did it get its start?
Amen.
Isaiah 2, Brother Fox. No, turn to Zechariah 1:16. But Isaiah 2 and verse 2, Isaiah said, it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountain, exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. All right, who's got it? Who's got it?
Therefore, thus says the Lord.
Nope. Isaiah, follow me along now. Follow along with me now. One of you fellas there by that mic, y'all have it. Isaiah 2 and verse number 2 to 4, you got it? What did it say, Brother Pettit?
And it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass.
In the last days.
Wait a minute. The last days means the last dispensation. Listen carefully. There have been three dispensations. Watch it. Patriarchal. It lasted from Adam to Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Then Mosaic, from Moses to Christ.
Right.
And from Christian, from Christ down to now.
Yes, sir.
Now, which one you think you're living in? You ain't living in the Mosaic. You ain't living in the patriotic.
Right.
Post-patriotic Mosaic. You're living in the Christian. Christian dispensation started the first Pentecost after the resurrection of Christ. All right, let's stop here. Slow it down a little bit.
Yes,
so last days, not talking about the approaching end of time. It's talking about the last dispensation.
Yes, sir.
Christian, keep reading.
That the mountains of the Lord's house should be established in the top of the mountain.
Read it.
It should be exalted above the hill.
Read it.
And all nations shall flow unto it.
Now stop. This particular church, everybody can fit in it. So it's not talking about a physical church.
Right.
It's spiritual.
Right.
Read it.
And many people shall go and say, come ye, and let us go up to the mountain of the house of the Lord.
Read it.
Or the God of Jacob.
Read it.
That he would teach us of his ways, And we were walking it past.
Read it.
For out of Zion shall go forth the law.
Read it.
And the word of the Lord from Jerusalem.
Now the place where this church got started is Jerusalem.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. If your church got started in America, it is not the Church of Christ.
Amen. Amen. Real good, preacher.
Now the Church of God in Christ got started in Memphis. That's the headquarters.
Right.
C.H. Mason. Mm-hmm. The Baptist Church started Providence, Rhode Island, well, Amsterdam, Holland. Then came to America in 1629 in Providence, Rhode Island. But it's not in the Bible.
Amen.
I'm preaching.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. The Methodist Church. It didn't start. It started in Oxford, England. John and Charles Wesley started it.
Right.
In 1729.
Amen.
You listening to me? Wrong place.
Amen.
Salt Lake City, Utah, Mormon church? No. The church that Jesus Christ built got started in the right place.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Right person, right place. Come on, Brother Fox, read it.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord, I am returned to Jerusalem.
I am returned to where?
Jerusalem.
Memphis.
Jerusalem.
Bethel.
Jerusalem.
Jerusalem. Read it.
With mercies.
Read it.
My house shall be built in it.
My house shall be built in it. The Church of Christ got started in Jerusalem.
Amen.
All right. I said, here, we got the right person. We got the right place. We got the right period. What the right period? It came to a certain time.
Yes, sir.
It didn't come any time. Got it? All right. Turn to Galatians, if you would, Brother Pettit. Galatians 4, verse 4. I got to read some of this. All right. All right. Read it, Brother Pettit.
But when the fullness of time was come.
When the fullness of time was come.
God sent forth his son. Made of a woman.
Made under the law.
To redeem them that were under the law.
Now watch this now. Watch it. When is this church going to start? What's the time frame? I just see, there have been four kingdoms. The Babylonian kingdom, Medo-Persian, you got it, and the Grecian kingdom. Are you listening to me? And you got a Roman kingdom. You got it? Now, watch it. In Daniel chapter 2 and verse number 44, I think that's what I want.
Mm-hmm.
Verse number 44. Let's do it quickly now. Brother Fox, what did it say?
And in the days of these kings.
I want
kings,
to get on that mic.
Read in it. The days of these kings.
Read it. In the days of these kings. What kingdom? The Roman kingdom. Read it.
Shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom.
Keep reading.
Which shall never be destroyed.
Read it.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Read it.
But it shall break in pieces and consume all now, these
when
kingdoms.
When did it happen? In the fullness of time. When? So we have the right person, right place, right period, right Pentecost. What do you mean right Pentecost? The church of our Lord, the church of Christ, got started in the city of Jerusalem about AD 33, right Pentecost. The first Pentecost after the resurrection of Christ from the dead, that's when the church of Christ got started.
Amen.
Now when did yours get started? The Catholic Church didn't get started in Jerusalem. The Catholic Church headquarters is in Rome, Italy.
Right.
Now, where's the headquarters of the Church of Christ? If you're looking on earth, you won't find it.
Right.
The headquarters of the Church of Christ is where the head is, Paul. And the head is in heaven.
Right.
So our headquarters is in heaven.
Right.
Amen, somebody. Amen. That's good.
Real good, preacher.
Amen.
Now, had a right Pentecost. Then we got the right preaching. They preached Christ. Got it? They preached Christ. They preached the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ. Acts chapter 2, verse 22 through 37.
Amen.
Then you have the right prerequisites to get in the church.
Amen.
Listen, they heard the gospel. They believed it. They repented of their sins. They confessed Christ. And they were baptized into Christ. And they were added to the church.
Right.
Got it? Now, right preaching, right prerequisites. Right requirements, right people part. And when they were added to this, they were saved.
Right.
Wait a minute. You need to look at this. These are identifying marks of the New Testament church.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, isn't that good?
Amen.
Let me slow it down a little bit. Don't want to lose anybody. We're having this on DVD.
Amen.
So you can go home and study.
Amen.
Is that good?
Amen.
Stay with me. Is that all right? Now, so we looked at decorations about the church. All of this is about the church. They were to read about the New Testament.
Right.
Got it? So far, so good. If it's the right place, person, right place, right period, right Pentecost, right preaching, right prerequisites, right people pardon, it couldn't be the wrong church.
Amen.
It's got to be the right church.
Amen.
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 All right. If it's the wrong person that started, Christ is the founder of the church.
Right.
Right? Wrong place. Anywhere in England, America? Nope.
Amen.
Wrong place. Wrong period. Can't be the right church.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, let's go over here a little bit. Now we're going to look at descriptions of the church. Descriptions.
Amen.
Amen. That pretty good?
Amen.
Now, somebody is real smart. And what they'll say, especially the Catholics, they'll say, do you have a succession of the Church of Christ from the day up of Jerusalem, from Jerusalem all the way down to now? Can you trace it? A line of churches that's been in succession ever since the church got started. Nope, can't do that. Mm-mm. You know, people, they think they're smart, but they're not smart as God. Now, wait a minute, let me show you something. You know, down in Florida, this time of year, they got watermelons.
Right.
Amen.
You don't know that? In Florida, they got watermelons.
Yes, sir.
Right now. Good, too.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you want, say, well, I want some of them watermelons that's in Florida, do you think that you have to go down to Florida and start growing a watermelon vine all the way from Florida to Tennessee to get to watermelon?
No, sir.
No. But what do? You get you some seeds.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Boy, that good preacher.
Amen.
You get you some seeds, watch it, and plant them in Florida, you get the same thing.
Right.
Right? Bring them on to Memphis, Tennessee, you get the same thing. And watch this here. God knew what he's doing. Description about the church. What are we going to use? First one. What is that, Brother Fox?
Origination.
Origination. We have seed there. Origination. Wait a minute. God started this thing off with a miracle. Then he used seed.
Yes, sir.
New seed.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you want a New Testament church, you got to use the seed.
Right.
Amen.
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 Luke 8:11. Brother, you ought to have it. Read it, Brother Fox.
Now the parable is this.
What?
The seed is the word of God.
Wait a minute. Y'all be looking at this now. The seed is the word of God. God has ordained that every seed brings seed out of the sky. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. If you want a church of Christ, watch it. In a part of the country where there's never been a church, what are you going to use? You don't use no Baptist manual.
No, sir.
Amen.
You use the seed.
Yes, sir.
What seed? The seed is the word of God. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got to make it plain. Say you go to a place and they never saw no corn. Never saw corn. And you wanted some corn there.
Amen.
Amen.
Plant the seed.
Right.
Every seed brings seed after its kind.
Right.
Right. You plant this right here in America, you get corn.
Right.
Take this to Africa and you plant it, you get corn.
Right.
Got it? Take it home with you, you get corn.
Amen.
Every seed brings seed of its kind.
Right.
You want the Church of Christ in your neighborhood, use the seed.
Right.
What's the seed? The word of God.
Amen. They're playing that preacher.
Oh boy. Pretty hard.
That's true.
Seed is the word of God.
Amen.
All right. Origination. Authorization. All right, brother, you got it. Read it.
Colossians. And whatsoever ye do in word.
Wait a minute. Authorization. Christ is the head of the church.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute, brother.
That's good.
No man is the head of this church.
Right. Mm-hmm. Make it plain.
Jesus Christ is the only head, and he gives all the direction for his church.
Right.
Amen. In matters of thing of salvation and worship.
Right.
Talk to me, somebody.
Right.
Read it, Brother Fox.
And whatsoever ye do in word or deed,
what?
Do all in the name of the Lord Jesus.
What do you mean, do all in the name? That means call and all, do things according to the gospel.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Organization. James 4. Read it, Brother Pettit.
There is one lawgiver.
Wait a minute. Hold it. James 4:12 says what?
There is one lawgiver.
Wait a minute. There's only one head.
Uh-huh.
Wait a minute. Listen to me carefully. The Church of Christ don't make no rules and regulations for the church.
No, sir.
The Lord made the rules for the church.
Amen.
And watch it. This is his last message.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. We don't meet and decide, here's a good one. You know, I looked at the Methodist Church, the Seventh-day Adventists, and the Baptists, and the Methodists, and all of them. Guess what they're doing? They're ordaining women as preachers.
Uh-huh.
They're ordaining women as preachers.
Yes, sir.
Watch this here. Now watch this here. There's no message from heaven to authorize that.
Right.
So guess what they do? Since they started it, they got their own church.
Right.
They start their own church.
Right.
They can put to who they want up
right.
there.
That's it, that preacher.
Who ever heard of a woman preacher in the church that Jesus built? Not one.
Amen.
No, sir.
Let me slow it down. Slow it down here. Who ever heard of a woman pastor of a church? And see, people who don't know the Bible, they'll go along with that foolishness.
Amen.
But see, if you got a woman, that is not the Church of Christ according to the New Testament.
Right.
Amen.
Whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Watch this here. Now watch this in there. Watch this. You all been watching TV over in Ireland. Listen to me carefully. They have voted same-sex marriages. But they're Catholics. They can do that.
Right.
Because that's their church. That's not the Church of Christ.
Right. Make it plain.
No such thing as same sex marriage in this book.
Right.
Oh, no. And wait a minute. God knew that people would change. They knew. That's why he gave us the seed.
Right.
And if you follow the seed is going to make one thing.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
One church and they're all Christian.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me, somebody.
Make a plan, preach.
All right. One lawgiver. Now watch this now. You got the Church of Christ in a universal sense. Please listen. Listen. Jesus said in Matthew 16, up on this rock I'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. That's Jesus Christ, his church in the universal sense.
Right.
Got it?
Amen.
Listen, the Church of Christ in a universal sense is compiled of all the saved.
Right.
Amen.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Has put all things under his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church, which is the body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. Now, listen carefully. You got the Church of Christ in the regional sense. Amen. Churches of Asia. Read it, Brother Fox.
John. To the seven churches which are in Asia.
Now, wait a minute. Individuals go over there and read that, and they think it's talking about seven different denominations.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you not listening. You ought to be listening. You're going to learn something.
Amen.
Brother Shannon is taking his time trying to school you.
Amen.
Now, it's called seven churches of what?
Asia.
What?
John to the seven churches.
That wasn't seven different denominations.
Right.
Well, how you know? Because all of them are made out of gold.
Right.
Then you have the Church of Christ in the local sense. Amen.
Amen.
Evangelist, look at 1 Timothy, Brother Pettit. Come on, Brother Pettit. 1 Timothy 4:16, Brother Fox, Brother White there, Philippians 1:1.
Take heed. Unto thyself.
And unto the doctrine.
Continue them.
Read it.
For in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee.
That's an evangelist in the local church.
Right.
That's what I am.
Right.
I'm not a pastor. I'm not a reverend.
Right.
I'm an evangelist in the church of Christ.
Right.
My name is John Shannon.
Yes, sir.
My name is not Reverend Shannon.
Right.
My name is not Pastor Shannon. I'm John Shannon.
Right.
That's it. Got to get it.
Mm-hmm.
Right here. The Apostle Paul, as great as he was, guess what they called him? Brother Paul.
Right.
Amen, somebody. That good? Philippians 1:1, read it.
Paul and Timotheus,
read it.
The servants of Jesus Christ, to
read
all
it.
The saints in Jesus Christ,
read it.
Which are at Philippi,
read it.
With the bishops and deacons.
Hold on. Look at it. Bishops and deacons. What do you mean bishops? Bishops, the word is plural. It's not single.
Right.
Bishops, elders, shepherds, pastors are the same group of men in a local church. Wait a minute. In a local church, there is no such thing as one bishop over 5 or 6 churches.
No, sir.
That is not the New Testament church.
Amen.
Who ever heard of a pastor got 2 churches, over 2 churches? Here's 2 pastors. Say Brother Joe Moses and Brother Pettit, or elders or bishops or pastors in this church. They don't have nothing to do with another congregation.
Right.
Coming overseeing it.
Right.
Amen, somebody.
You're right. Right.
Amen. Then you have the Church of Christ. Watch it. And the assembled church.
Amen.
Wait a minute. Look at it. 1 Corinthians there. Come on down. Brother, you see this? You got it, Brother Pettit? Read it. 1 Corinthians 11:2.
Now I praise you,
what?
Brethren, that ye remember me in all things.
Read it.
And keep the ordinance as I deliver them to you.
That's talking about in the local sense. You got it? Verse 17 says what, Brother Fox? Read it. Brother Petty, you got it? Read
now
it.
In this,
what?
I declare unto you,
what?
I praise you not.
Read it.
That ye come together not for the better, but for the worse.
Keep reading.
For first of all, when ye come together in the church, I hear that there be division among you.
Keep reading.
And I partly believe it.
Read it.
For there must be also hearers among you.
Read it.
That they which are approved may be made manifest among you.
Now the point is, when you come together in the church, in the one place, please listen. This whole idea of where 2 or 3 are gathered together in my name, there I'm in the midst, that's false doctrine.
Right.
You can't say, well, we're going to meet over here. No, you got to come together in one place.
Right.
You don't go to your house to have services.
Right.
No, that's what this place is for.
Right.
But keep it in the context. Jesus said, where 2 or 3 are gathered together in my name, he was speaking of withdrawing fellowship from a disorderly brother.
Right.
That's the context, and not worship.
Amen.
That's good, preacher.
We come here to worship. Where's that place there? Brother Pettit, what that scripture there, 1 Corinthians.
When ye come together,
what?
Therefore, in one place.
One place. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. You remember the James Road Church of Christ? Yep. You had to come together in one place.
Yes, sir.
You can't meet it, so well, we're going to meet in my house. Oh, no. If you want to start your own church, go and start your own church. Don't divide the church.
Right.
Amen. Now we stop right there. Let me pull this around here. Yes. Oh boy. Yes. Pretty good.
Good.
Hey man. I'm teaching here. You see that? Look at this. Autonomy. What in the world is autonomy? It means self-rule, self-government.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. I want y'all in the back. And see, I see everybody when you move and you're not paying attention. It distracts me.
Man.
I see everything.
Right.
You ought to listen. Each local congregation of a Church of Christ is, watch it, is self-rule, self-governed. And what do you mean self-rule, self-governed? The North Road Church, the South Haven Church of Christ, or any other church can't tell us what time to have service.
Right.
They can't do that.
Right.
They can't tell us what we can do and what we can't do.
Uh-huh.
We're self-government.
Right.
Self-rule. Yeah. Wait a minute. You need to listen to this. Autonomous means, watch it, we're individuals.
Right.
Individual congregation. Yeah. Got our own leadership.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me, somebody. Amen. Got it?
Right.
How? When it comes to the Holy Bible, all of these congregations are regulated by the Holy Bible.
Right.
Got it? Now, if this church right here stop following the Bible, watch it. We don't have the fellowship then.
Right.
No. Watch how it is. Say false doctrine comes in the church. Now, the church is not set up like this. It's set up like this.
Right.
Well, what do you mean, Brother Shannon? See how it is when false doctrine hit here and say this is a window pane, the whole thing shatters.
Right.
See, when Catholicism start their false doctrine and it comes from the Rome or the Pope, it shatters, make the whole thing messed up.
Right.
But over here, God set it up like this. Each one of these are autonomous, self-government. Uh-huh. We follow the Bible. Say that they decide they want to use mechanical instruments of music in church worship. False doctrine is in it. But right. It didn't affect the rest of them.
Amen. Right. That's good. Preach.
Wait a minute. You ever see a window pane there, Doc? And the little boy take a rock and throw it and hit it. Guess what happened? It just bust one pane out. You got it? But if you got a big pane here and he throw a rock, it shattered the whole thing.
Right.
God didn't set up the church like this. He set it up like individuals following the scripture.
Amen.
You got it? So if one mess up, all of them are not messed up.
What a good preacher. Amen.
Now watch this. Say this church here at 2400 James. Say we started with a choir and a band. Start having winning preachers. We start clapping and jumping and all that. Guess what? We seek to be the Lord's church, but it will affect the church over here that's doing right.
Right.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Brethren, we follow the Bible.
Right.
We watch the brethren just like we watch the Baptists.
Right. Right, preacher.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, some of my brethren are trying to do this. They trying to make the church like this, where you got a central headquarters. And whatever this headquarters say, it affects the whole thing. None of that.
No,
God wants each local congregation to have its own leadership
right.
and take care of its own business.
Right.
So if one of them mess up, it didn't mess them all up.
Right.
Isn't God wonderful?
Man.
Colossians 3:15. Let's read it.
And let the peace of God.
Peace of God.
Rule in your
heart. Heart.
To
read
the which also ye are called in one body.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. The one body is the church.
Right.
What? See, God called us in the one body. Now watch this now. Please listen to this. Please listen. You can't join the church in a universal sense. Listen.
Make it plain, preacher.
You cannot join the church of Christ in a universal sense. Because when you obey the gospel, the Lord adds you to the church.
Amen.
That's the universal sense.
Right.
But you can join a congregation in the local sense.
Right.
Wait a minute.
That's it. Make it plain, preacher.
Turn. What is that passage? Acts. It's in Galatians. We'll get it. Amen. It acts. Brother Peter, you got it? Saved. Paul, a saved to join the disciples. Amen. That's good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Your brother ought to have that here. Amen. That's good, isn't it? Brother Sanders, you know where you're going? I know exactly where I'm going. Amen. That's pretty good, isn't it? All right, look at Acts chapter 9.
26.
Verse number 26.
Okay.
Everybody turn there.
Mm-hmm.
Let me show you what I'm saying here now. Acts 9:26.
Uh-huh.
Look at it. All right, we're doing good. Please pay attention. All right, who's going to read it, Brother Fox? You're going to read it? Read it.
And when Saul was come to Jerusalem.
And when Saul was come to Jerusalem. Now, this Saul of Paul had obeyed the gospel now.
Right.
He had faith, repentance, confession. He was baptized into Christ.
Right.
He was added to the church.
Right.
That's in the universal sense.
Uh-huh.
But keep reading.
He assayed.
He what?
Assayed.
A what?
Assayed.
Now, wait a minute. Spell it, Brother Fox.
A-S-S.
A-S-S.
A-Y.
A-Y.
E-D.
E-D. Now, you know what assayed means? He tried.
Yes, sir.
What does aid mean? He tried.
Yes, sir.
So he essayed to do what?
To join himself to the disciples. But they were all afraid of
Wait
him.
Wait a minute. He tried to join the disciples at Jerusalem.
Right.
He was already a member of the church, but he wanted to place his membership in a certain congregation.
Right.
But because of his bad reputation, they were scared of him.
Right. Right, preach.
Then it says what? Read it.
And believe not that he was a disciple.
Keep reading.
But Barnabas took him.
What?
And brought him to the apostles.
Read it.
And declared unto them how he had seen the Lord.
Wait just a minute. Hey. He obeyed the gospel.
Right.
And they accepted him.
Amen.
In that sense, he joined the local congregation.
Right.
But he didn't join the church universally, and you can't either.
Right.
Now let me explain.
Real good.
Brother and sister North Lee, they come to James Road Church. They obeyed the gospel down in Mississippi. They may say, well, Brother Shannon, I think I'm going to change my membership to Horn Lake and Levi. They can go join themselves with the disciples down there.
Right.
Right? But let me tell you something. When you leave here, we're going to send a letter with you to Horn Lake and Levi to let them know that you weren't a troublemaker.
Right. That's good, preacher.
A lot of times people want to come here and troublemakers where they were and come here on a clean shake. Oh, no, we're watching everybody.
Right.
Oh, no, we got to watch you.
Amen.
That's what you do in the school system.
Right.
You don't be at one school and join another one and got a bad reputation. Oh, no, they got a letter in your records
right.
about you.
That's good, preacher.
We need to have a record on everybody here. Amen, amen somebody.
Right.
That good? Oh, boy, that's pretty good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Did I miss anything? Trying to get through here. Oh, isn't that good?
Real good.
Amen. Now, so we got that, right? Now, location of salvation. Where is salvation? It's in Christ. Ephesians 1:3, all spiritual blessings in heavenly places are in Christ. Galatians 3:26-27, for you all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. For as many as you have been baptized into Christ, have put on Christ.
Right.
Watch this. Once you're baptized into Christ, you're added to the church.
Right.
You say, you, amen.
Amen.
Now, amen. So you hear the gospel, Acts 15:7, and believe it. You got to repent of your sins. You confess Christ. Watch it. You be baptized into Christ. You be blessed. You behave, and you broadcast.
Uh huh.
Come on, Paul. That good?
Really?
Now watch this now. Listen. Listen to me carefully. To become a member of the Church of Christ, you don't go to no morning bench.
Right. Amen. Make it plain, preacher.
Wait a minute. Denominational people have been freaking my black people ever since they brought us over here.
Amen.
Gotta go to the morning bench and get religion. Right. That ain't in the Bible.
Amen.
Come to the altar and raise your hand and ask God to save you. That stuff is not in the Bible. Wait a minute. Child, I fetch religion today. That ain't in the Bible.
No, sir.
Everybody that obeyed the gospel, they were added to the same church.
Amen.
In a universal sense. They heard the gospel. They believed it. They repented of sins. They were baptized into Christ for the remission of sins. Wait a minute. No, they didn't get no religion. No. They didn't get no religion. Where are you getting it from?
Man.
I got it. No. Stop that junk.
Amen.
You don't get no religion.
Right.
I went to the morning. No. No. If you went to the morning bench, you're not saved.
Right.
Amen. All right.
Make it plain, preacher.
Going to hell, too.
All right. Make it plain.
Where are you going? Going to hell.
Right.
What if you are being a church that can't be identified with it? You're on your way to hell.
Amen.
Amen. Brother Sanders, you're all not. See, you're still in your sins.
Make it plain, preacher.
Wait a minute. If I can't convince you through the preaching of gospel that you're in your sin, you're going to hell, you ain't going to ever change.
Right.
If you're in a church, not in the Bible, on your way to hell, you cannot be saved in something that Jesus didn't build.
Right.
Well, we're doing a lot of good work. The KKK is doing a lot of good work.
Right. Right, preacher.
We're talking about going to heaven.
It's good.
Amen. Now you're saved. You've been added to the church. What are you called? Wait a minute. Look at this. Now we're going to talk about adoration. John 4:24, Acts 2:42. That was worship. God is the Spirit. They that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Listen to this. You cannot worship God in an acceptable way unless you're in Christ or in His church.
Right.
And in His church, no mechanical instruments of music.
Right.
All that hand clapping and jumping. You're not worshiping yourself.
Right.
We got to worship God.
Amen.
And we worship God the way He tells us to worship Him.
Right.
Amen. Amen. Acts of worship. Pray. Who should pray? Every member of the Church of Christ.
Right.
Preaching, that's what I'm doing now. Singing, amen. Giving, Lord's Supper.
Yes, sir.
What else? Every first day of the week. If you go to a church where they don't have the Lord's Supper every first day of the week, or they have it every day, that's the wrong church.
Right.
Designation, they're called churches of Christ.
Uh-huh.
They're called the church of God.
Uh-huh.
They're called the church. They call the kingdom. They call the household of faith. They call the body of Christ. They call the churches of Christ. And they call the church of God.
Yes, sir.
This is a church of God.
Yeah, man. Make it plain,
but you got to understand, it's the God that had the church. Okay. It's Jesus Christ.
Right.
It's called the body of Christ.
Right.
Right? And you can call the New Testament church anything that the New Testament calls it.
Yes,
but you cannot call it something that the Bible doesn't call it.
Right.
Amen. Continuation in what? In the book. Continue steadfastly in the apostle doctrine, fellowship, breaking bread. Not only continuation, but regulation. You can't live any way you want. A lot of members of the Church of Christ, it's some here.
All right.
It's some members of the Church of Christ here. If they don't turn around, they're going to bust hell right open.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
What you say?
Yes, sir.
That's exactly right.
Amen.
In Titus 2, verse 11 and 12, it said, "For the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared unto all men,
uh-huh,
teaching us that denying ungodly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world." A lot of members of the Church of Christ smoke dope, drink whiskey, shack up, have sex outside of marriage.
Help us, preacher.
Right? Do drugs, lie, cheat, steal. Do you have any idea in your head that you can practice that and then when you die you go to heaven? Do you really believe that? Don't believe that. A lot of members of the Church of Christ, I'm a member of the Church of Christ, and I was, but I don't have to be faithful. You ain't going to heaven.
Amen.
That's good, preacher.
Turn if you would. I'm preaching now.
Yes, sir.
Turn to Hebrews 3, verse number 12 and 13. Members of the Church of Christ, you need to listen to this. Somebody said, "I don't like this kind of preaching." I know that's why I'm doing it. I'm trying to snatch you out of the fire, and you may. You ought to hug my neck for preaching like this.
Amen.
Oh, these churches of Christ now, most of them, they ain't preaching nothing.
Amen.
Because they're scared.
Right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Hebrews chapter 3 and verse number 12, read it.
Take heed, brethren.
Wait a minute. Paul told the Hebrew Christians who's about to go back to Judaism, Paul said, take heed, brethren, what?
Lest there be in any of you,
what?
An evil heart of unbelief.
In
departing from the living God.
When you stop practicing the Bible, you're departing from God.
Amen.
That's good, preacher.
You better take heed to yourself.
Amen. That's good, preacher.
Departing from the living God.
Amen.
Somebody said, well, I'm not going to be faithful. You don't have to be faithful. Don't be faithful.
Amen.
Don't be faithful. That's what the devil tells you.
Right.
But I'll tell you one thing.
Yes, sir.
1 30 seconds in hell, you change your mind, but it'll be too late.
Right.
Amen.
Somebody says, I'm not going to be favored. I'm not going to give. I'm going to do what I want to do. I'm going to have sex with anybody I want to. I'm going to shack. I'm going to sell. I'm going to do anything. Go ahead. You won't be the only one in hell.
Amen.
A lot of young people going to be in hell. Because they won't listen.
Right.
We got some in the Church of Christ right here. Won't hardly do right.
Right.
Ain't coming back at all. You'll burn.
Amen.
He'll burn your hide.
Yes, sir.
Of a truth, God is no respecter person.
Right.
He don't care nothing about you.
Right.
Being black, he'll burn your hide.
Amen.
You young people, you need to listen. He'll burn your hide. If you die in your sins, where I am, you can't come. You got some older people in here that needs to straighten up.
Careful,
a lot of older people in here ready to die and still ain't right with God.
Amen.
Better get right.
Yes, sir. Amen.
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 Brother Shannon, you mad? No. I'm trying to help somebody.
Amen.
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 You gonna get right?
All right.
Regulation. Operation. What do you mean? Ephesians 2:10, watch it. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, under good work. Wait a minute, what do you mean operation? The church has got to operate.
Right.
What? The Bible tells us there's some works in the church.
Right.
There's edification, that's building the saints up.
Right.
There's evangelization, that's seeking and saving the lost. And then there's benevolence for saints and sinners.
Right.
Now let me ask a question. Out of those three places, where are you working?
That's good, preacher.
Wait a minute. If you think that you're going to go to heaven just because you live right and you worship every Sunday and you don't do none of the works of the church, if you think you're going to heaven, you're wrong.
Help us, preacher.
These are works of faith that
right.
You got to do.
Amen.
Everybody.
Amen. Right, preacher.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
A lot of members of the church leave and go out and don't want to do anything, come in and sin and repent, rather, and leave and go back and do the same thing.
Right.
And as wishing, you ain't wishing you going to heaven. You ain't going to heaven like that. You got to dedicate your life totally
right.
To the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes,
amen.
Good, amen, somebody.
Good.
Build up, broadcast benevolence. Destination. Look at here. 1 Peter 1:9. Come on, brethren. 1 Peter 1:9 says what?
Receiving the end of your faith.
What?
Even the salvation of your soul.
Do it again. Receive the what?
The end of your faith.
The what?
The end.
The what?
End.
Listen to this. Look. Look, here you are right here. The end. Wait a minute. See right here? Look. Start here. End.
Yes, sir.
Everybody start here. You go end.
All right.
If receiving the end of your faith. If you haven't been faithful, what do you think you're going to get? Preach, Brother Shannon.
Right.
Amen.
Read it.
Receiving the end of your faith.
What is?
Even the salvation of your soul.
Is that right? Brother Pettit, read verse 4 and 5. Read it.
To an inherent incorruptible and
read
undefiled,
it.
And that fadeth not away.
Where is?
Reserved in heaven for you.
Where is it?
In heaven.
Where?
In heaven.
Wait a minute. You want your crown? You got to receive the end of your faith. You got to be faithful.
Right.
Wait a minute. God never told us to be perfect in the sense of not making mistakes. But there's one thing he told us is to be faithful.
Right.
Wait a minute. You can be faithful. You got to be faithful. Are you faithful? Amen. That's the destination. Now watch this. Similarity does not prove identical.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Somebody said, well, my church is like this in one sense. No, it's got to be all the way.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Michael, that's nothing.
Good, preacher.
Amen, somebody.
Amen. Amen. Preaching.
Are you listening?
Amen.
That's pretty good. We have anybody here today that's not a member of the body of Christ and you want to be saved. You want to be saved? Faith, repentance, confession, baptism into Christ for the remission of sin. You don't have to go no mourning bench. You don't have to do none of that. You don't have to get up and give no personal testimony. None of that. Amen, somebody.
We certainly hope that you've enjoyed this lesson. Thank you as always. God bless you.
Yes, Lord.